Hello, I'm Stephen Roy Goodman, host of Higher Education Today. I'm here in Bucharest, Romania, where we'll be talking about educational collaboration in Romania and the United States. Adrian Curaj is the Minister of National Education and Scientific Research for Romania. Ioan-Aurel is the rector of the Babes-Bolyai University in Cluj, Romania. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Minister, if we can start with you. I know there's all this protocol about the collaboration, but I really had to ask you about the laser. My understanding is that you are one of the main proponents of this new laser project that is going to be in Romania. Could you say a word or two about that?
Yeah, and I thank you. And I think the laser subject is one of a nice, beautiful possible example for collaboration between universities themselves with the research institutes as well as with business. And in 2006, Romania started being a partner in a pan-European project aiming to develop the most powerful laser facilities in the world. Romania is hosting, I try to keep my story short, long story short. Romania is in a position to host the laser experiments in nuclear physics, extreme light infrastructure in nuclear physics. And I think it is something at the frontier of science and technology, and it is not only my perception, it's the perception of amazing, beautiful scientists working on the subject.
And are you working with other countries as well?
Yes, of course, we are working internationally because developing something real at the frontier of science and technology, something of uniqueness in the world, definitely unique, all the beauty of science and the capacity of people and companies to put things together. Yes, we are working with partners in Europe, also we are working with partners from US.
Fair enough. And if we can speak to the issue of Cluj, I know you're a historian, Mr.
Yes.
Rector, but I assume you have scientific research going on in Cluj as well.
Of course.
Maybe if you could say a word or two about some of the collaborations that you've been involved in with the United States and elsewhere from Cluj.
We have relations with around 25 universities in the States. Everything started only after the fall of the communist regime. And we are cooperating in both fundamental sciences and in social sciences, humanities, starting with, for example, Arizona State University and ending with the University of Georgia at Athens, University of Pittsburgh, University of Michigan. So in every field, we found a lot of possibilities of cooperation. And we are very proud that, for example, through our Faculty of Political Science, we created a postgraduate program with Michigan State with double degree, Romanian and American.
And you yourself studied at the University of Pittsburgh, did I?
Yes, when I was younger, after the fall of the communist regime, I was among the first Romanian cohorts as a Fulbright visiting professor at the University of Pittsburgh, the oldest university situated to east of Allegheny in the States. I am saying that because our university is the oldest and the biggest in Romania in this very moment, Babes-Bolyai, and it was quite an experience. It was my first view on American educational system.
And what did you think were some of the similarities and differences?
Oh, first of all, there are a lot of differences. But now, after 25 years, I would say that we adapted ourselves. And now the similarities are quite important in this very moment. I am thinking on brainstorming, speaking with students, relations between professors and students. Everything is a little bit more American in a way.
Well, and speaking of more American, Mr. Minister, I know you represent the country of Romania, not the country of the United States here, but do you have some thoughts or two about how education has changed in Romania since the end of communism?
Yeah, definitely. Education has been changing a lot since communist years. And if it is to put a few action lines of these changes, first, and it was the main driver, was about people mobility. Mm-hmm. And freedom of mobility. And Rector Pop already said, if the universities today are, let's say, internationally compatible, and also they are performing well internationally, it's because people moved, come back, go in different countries, including US, used extensively Fulbright context and facilities. Also universities, Romanian universities benefited a lot from US professors coming here. And that's why now we have a lot of study program in English on different subjects from technical area and coming from to the social sciences so Romanian universities are internationally adapted. They are trying and used to compete for being ranked properly. We invested a lot in driving and pushing them to be more visible internationally. And at the end of the day, actually, our message and my message is go globally. Go globally, not because you are the best globally, but go globally, internationalizing your higher education and research activities. I think things are going to go to move in a good direction.
And speaking of the direction, do you have some initiatives that you're prepared to speak about that you're working on that you think are going to move that even forward?
Yeah, there are many initiatives, but I will point out something very much connected with our discussion today. First, it's our intention to have to support a better dialogue and closer dialogue between universities in Romania and universities in US. I know the links are between them, but facilitating it's important. But also facilitating a little bit the links with research entities, public and private. That's why we are very close our effort to open an office for higher education, science, innovation, and entrepreneurship in US, Romanian office, just to be a sort of interface between Romanian community and what is happening in US. Because actually, I do really hope not only to have one-by-one cooperation, I want to see some critical mass in defined areas of interest. Agriculture 4.0. If we talk about laser and nuclear physics, definitely we need nuclear photonics, also nuclear forensic and data security. You know, Romania is quite good in ICT and in related technologies.
Well, is there something like the National Science Foundation here where people could get funding for some of the research that, like, our scientists would get in the United States?
Yeah, okay. Unfortunately or not, I don't know. I was the director of this National Science Foundation funding agency for the last 20 years. Yes, and there are some things very nice, interesting from the internationalization point of view. By the way, not all the countries are open for foreigners to be principal investigators. It is not the case in Romania. Romania is accepting everybody having proper quality to be principal investigator and to apply for grants in Romania. Also, research grants are mobile. So it is a huge effort of the universities and research labs to keep inside the best of the best. And Romania also is open and keen to have foreign experts coming here. And we have been one of the countries applying the scientist passport, making the life easier for those wanting to come in Romania and to work in the research groups in Romania. There are many other things, but anyhow.
Fair enough. And in Cluj, you must have some of these leading researchers who are coming to Cluj.
You must know that Cluj is called, not only here in Romania, Silicon Valley of Romania, because in the field of IT and informatics, we are the best. In a city counting around 400,000 people, they are working around between 17,000 and 18,000 specialists in IT. And our university, it's leading this field together with a technical university from Cluj-Napoca. In another, in an, in the same way, I would like to say that we are cooperating with a lot of companies, and this was an American lesson. We have our own, let's say, board of trustees trying to cooperate with industry, with companies, because for the university it's the future. And I think that in this field, together with our faculty and students, we are able to do a lot of good things. And even the way of using European funds, for example. We have a European program called Erasmus, and Erasmus Plus means to cooperate with extra EU, extra European countries, and the relationship between Romanian universities and United States are developing during the last years through this Erasmus Plus program. Exchanges, lectures, and even more common researches and publication of these researches in the main periodicals, reviews, best quoted.
Interesting. Well, one of the things you just mentioned a second ago was the issue of taking the model of the connection with businesses.
Yes.
As you probably know, that's a very controversial subject in the United States. Is that a controversial subject here in Romania as well?
It would be, but now, you know, our experience in this field is not so long and so important as it was in the States. I presume even less good things are not so obvious here. We are trying to use the good things in our cooperation to adapt ourselves to the needs of the market, but in the same time to keep the research and the education at a very high level.
Well, that's also interesting because the needs of the market, we keep thinking of that, are our universities research centers? Do they do basic research like laser research before they become applied?
Yes.
Or are we simply trying to train people so they can get a job tomorrow morning? What are we trying to do? And so maybe if you wouldn't mind addressing that, how you do it in inclusion, maybe how you look at that kind of countrywide.
I think we are trying to keep a balance between the need of having excellent specialists in the field of fundamental research and between the need of the market to have tomorrow or today very good specialists to work immediately. We need to balance things because universities are quite laboratories for the future.
Science has no any frontiers, so if it is to have a contribution in basic science, as I suppose we will have here in Romania, in the context of the uniqueness of facilities, laser and nuclear physics, definitely you need the best of the best coming here, and to have them, you have to have a proper, let's say, innovation ecosystem. They have to live, they have to work, nice, beautiful living, nice, beautiful working, nice context. And this is part of the answer. The second part of the answer is about the business needs and the industry's needs. Definitely, you have also to provide needed skills at the territorial level. So in Europe, we are talking about smart specialization, how a selecting number of interdisciplinary areas you expect to do very good job. And definitely you have to focus your efforts in providing needed skills on different levels, including those skills of PhD, yeah, to respond to the market needs. So it's a complex answer. But anyhow, I like very much what Rector said about
Silicon Valley
of Romania. And the area where extreme light infrastructure, nuclear physics, laser is situated, we branded it as Laser Valley, Land of Lights.
Laser Valley, Land of Lights?
Yeah.
That's very catchy.
Yeah.
If you ever decide to give up your job, you can go into advertising. That's great.
Yeah, first you have to, let's say, try to sell a nice, beautiful, not disconnected view, dream. Not disconnected with reality, because reality is there. Right. It's a huge concentration of public and private facilities, including this one. But also having a nice, beautiful brand is not so bad.
But speaking of the brand, if you, as a minister, say to the rectors of different universities, this is what we would like you to do, do you have that power, or do you just suggest what they ought to do?
Yeah, you have the power to suggest. Yes, of course, universities in Romania are really autonomous. Definitely, at the central level, you have some mechanisms trying to, let's say, put some colors on their evolution. By the way, if it is about putting a sort of extra resources for those universities, we expect to play a role more than a regional one. Could be an international role. Definitely, we have to have some active policies on this direction. But also, I think, and this is important, universities are autonomous, are freedom. They are free to decide, free to be a real player on the open market.
And how do you interact with the government more broadly than just, you know, our friend right here? I mean, how do you interact with the government generally in terms of regulations or in terms of other things that might affect the university?
Again, European and Romanian experience is a little bit different because of our centralization, which was not only during the communist regime, even before a little bit, because we applied in the modern time the French pattern, the French model. So we have a special organization of the field, and I feel that we need more autonomy in the university, but in the same time, our universities, our best universities, are state universities. So we need to interfere, we need to cooperate with the state, because it's a nature of things to do it. But I think we are trying to doing well, especially during the last 10 years.
It is something to add here. Of course, autonomy and responsibility. So public accountability of universities, yes, it is one of our central job to explain and to do everything for extending the autonomy, but also for working with universities in taking the responsibility of being open and to present clear what they are doing and how they administrate autonomy.
Yes.
Well, we struggle with this in the United States. We, as you probably both know, we have a lot of social issues going on our campuses that revolve around political issues involving students mostly, where students feel that they don't have the ability to speak out, or they have too much ability to speak out, or not enough ability to speak out. And we have a number of universities that are embroiled in all sorts of political situations when, in fact, the administration doesn't really know what to do.
Yes, the dialogue, it's not so smooth even here, because after 25 years of democracy in Europe, students are very active in Romania now, and they have very strong organizations. On the other side, it's trade union of faculty. So it's a dialogue, a kind of social dialogue between the administration of the university, rector, vice rectors, and so on, and our main public way of working, which is represented by the huge amount of students. In my university, we have 42,000 students. So it's quite a challenge to work with the students, and we exist for students, not students for faculty. So faculty must adapt to the needs of the students, and it wasn't so easy, because during the communist regime, everything was dictated by the center, by the capital city.
I'm coming from structured dialogue, working in future studies and foresight for policies in higher education and research. And from my point of view, working with students is part of the inclusiveness participation of stakeholders.
Yes.
And definitely I want to see, and it is my very clear position, I want to see them active actors. And that's why I used to invite them for any nice or not so nice subjects to be discussed together with trade unions, together with stakeholders, with private companies. Why? Because actually, exactly, we are doing for them. Because they are actually, at the end of the day, the final destination of what we are doing. We invest in them.
Fair enough. And how would you interact with our Department of Education in Washington? Do you interact with our Department of Education in Washington?
No, not directly. But anyhow, being for almost 3 years member of the board of Fulbright program in Romania, we have done a lot of nice, beautiful things. And I think if even if not directly, indirectly, we managed to decide some nice, beautiful programs. And I will give you some examples. It is not only having in Romania the half a nice Fulbright program. That means universities mm-hmm. are putting some skin in, and coming from entrepreneurial also, some skin in, and they put some money for the professors, experts from US coming here. So is a cost sharing between the Fulbright program and universities, half a nice in here, but also is something I heard just a few days ago about half-anizing in US. A group of students from Romania are now Fulbright grantees mm-hmm. with part of the funds coming from Romania in an attempt to develop the entrepreneurial education in Romania. And I do believe soon we will also have something like this in the data science and big data.
Well, that's interesting you mentioned big data, because as you no doubt know, I mean, that's a huge field in the United States. And we have a ton of researchers who are working on that around the clock in our Silicon Valley.
Yes. Of course.
Yes, and we are not waiting. We are doing a lot. We, at the country level, we are working in different groups in cognitive sciences. And I think we are doing a very good job in this. And people mobility, normal now, helps us a lot. But again, it is not about what is happening by chance. It's what we are trying to do in a systematic way, opening up new ways of collaboration. And I think Fulbright is something amazing, because it is a well-known, reputated vehicle, and we may extend it. It is part of what we are doing with the Department of State.
And we use this opportunity in Romania. We used a lot after the fall of the communist regime, Fulbright, I mean, as a way of adapting ourselves to the needs of new directions in higher education. It was quite an opportunity. And I have to mention here very good relations with the American embassy since 1990 till today. Every American ambassador was guest of our university and presented in different fields the priorities of American education. And so the dialogue and the communication were very, very important for this way of acting.
But also the way we are working with the U.S. Embassy here, it's important, because we are developing the U.S.-Romania partnership, including science and innovation, including education. And there are points, very nice points and up-to-date points about what we expect to have in higher education. And we put a lot of things, and what are the areas of both interests, even is bioeconomy, lasers and its application, on even different applications for health industry, coming from the uniqueness of the infrastructure of laser and nuclear physics.
Well, fair enough. We only have a few minutes left. So maybe if Mr. Rector, if there was something that you wanted to say about Cluj and the direction that you were trying to go in, that would be helpful.
Yes, Cluj has a very special personality in the field of Romanian higher education, because we are trying to adapt ourselves to the multicultural way of being today in a global world. In our university, we have three official languages, Romanian, Hungarian, and German, and a lot of programs in English, French, Italian. We are promoting centers and institutes for cultural centers and institutes around 25. For example, the last were created in the university were Center of Indian Studies and Center of African Studies, Center of Brazilian Studies. So we are trying to promote this dialogue, because the philosophy of our university is to communicate and to have a dialogue with the world in order to improve the whole world.
And fair enough. And Mr. Minister, why don't we give you the last word? Or is there anything that you would like to say going forward that you would prefer for our collaborative efforts to focus on?
Yeah, I don't know if it is about focusing, but for us it's important to continue orchestrating the developments in Romania, in innovation ecosystem. Universities are part of them, research is part of, just to offer better condition of cooperation between different actors from Romania and US, even if they are universities, research labs, or private companies. And I think this is the core message. Romania is prepared for internationalization of its higher education and research, not in theory, in practice.
And you see that for students and for professors?
For students and professors, definitely, because for professors it's a mixture between educating and doing research. And I think we have nice, beautiful conditions and people doing here research for offering them a nice, beautiful, challenging environment for doing research and education. It is also about students, because I think from cultural point of view, from historical point of view, for the quality of life and the lifestyle, there are a lot of things to be shared between those moving from here in US, from those from US coming here.
Well, why don't we leave it at that? Thank you. And that's a great point. Thank you. And I'd like to encourage more of that. Thank you, Mr. Minister, for coming on. Mr. Rector, thank you for coming on. Yes. For additional information about the Romanian Minister of Education or the BBU Rector, please visit edu.ro or ubbcluj.ro. If you have comments or suggestions about higher education today, please send an email to our viewer mailbox at higher education today@topcolleges.com. Special thanks to UDC-TV and the Romanian Public Television here in Bucharest. I'm Stephen Roy Goodman, and you've been watching Higher Education Today.